Minasan konnichiwa. Hello everyone. Today we are going to learn kanji characters which are the names of seasons in a year. First, as you may guess from the picture, spring. In this picture, a temple or shrine, cherry trees and the sun are seen. Please look closely to the temple. Different floors and the slopes on both sides are noticeable. The reflection of the sun in front looks like the stairs to the temple. In springtime, when cherry trees blossom under the sun, it is enjoyable visiting temples and shrines around. So when we see this kanji figure, we can remember temple or shrine visit in spring. Inside the temple, there is a room called Hanami room. In this room, best scenery is viewed. But don't forget to take off your shoes and boots before you enter. You know, walking inside the temple with shoes are not allowed. When you focus on the bold written syllables here, first you get Haru from Hanami room expression as kun reading, and then Shun from shoes and blah blah expression as on reading of this kanji. Now stroke orders and examples. We have three examples. First, Haru meaning springtime. Second, Raishun meaning next spring. And third, Seishun meaning youth, in other words, springtime of life. Please check their usages in shown sentences. Now the second kanji meaning summer. First, we should know these two radicals used in this kanji. They have also widespread usages in forming several other kanji characters. The radical above represents head, like part of our body. It looks like the head emoji. The radical below is used to indicate the action going slowly. Together, the formed kanji looks like a walking head. Be careful, head. In summer, walking under the sun is not so difficult for short distances. On the other hand, for long distances, it becomes tiring. Then you walk slowly. So this kanji figure may remind us slowly going head on a hot summer day. Let's think that a friend of such a walking man surprisingly says it's no good walking under the bright sun. Are you nuts? Go get in the car. The bold written words in the speech balloon give us kun and on readings which are natsu and ka respectively. Now stroke orders and examples. First example is Natsuyasumi, which means summer vacation. Second example is Honka, which is a way of saying this summer. Now let's review today's first two kanji figures once more. First one is spring kanji. We can remember it from temple or shrine visit in spring. Its kun reading is Haru, remember Hanami room of the temple. And on reading is Shun, remember taking off shoes and boots before entering temple. Second one is summer kanji. You can see tired and going slowly man in this figure. Kun reading is natsu, remember are you nuts expression. And on reading is ka, remember get in the car expression. Now it's time to move on to the third kanji, which means autumn season in English. This kanji consists of two parts. First part is branched tree, second part is fire kanji. In the picture, there seems a preparation for a picnic or camping. Important point is, campers should pay attention for the camping fire not to flare up. Or because of heat, the color of the leaves of the tree may change to red or brown just like in autumn. So when you see the shape of this kanji, think about the camping fire in autumn, which may cause leaves change color. You know, in autumn, one of the best social activities is going to a movie theater. Think about Akira Kurosawa, famous film director, and imagine that you are watching one of his movies. You realize then that his way of shooting films is incredible. So you can remember the kun reading Aki from Akira Kurosawa and on reading Shu from his shooting films which you watched in autumn. Now let's see stroke orders and examples. There are two examples. First, Aki itself, meaning autumn season. Second, Sakushu, meaning last fall. Please check the sentences given on the screen. And we have come to the last kanji for today, which means the winter. There's a winter scenery here. The snowman is skating. Please see the moving or walking or going radical next to snowman's figure. Plus two snowflakes make winter kanji. Skating snowman is happy to see two big snowflakes. He enjoys the beauty of winter. When we see this kanji figure somewhere, we can remember snowman moving ahead on snow and welcoming two big snowflakes. And all this give us the meaning of this kanji, which is winter. Because he is happy, he may say, I can make a full European tour in this way. In this speech balloon, first syllables of full European expression, which sound like few, give us the kun reading, and to from the word tour gives us the on reading of this kanji. Now let's check the stroke orders and examples. We have three examples. First, fuyu, meaning winter. Second, tōmin, meaning hibernation. And third, tōki, meaning winter season. Please try to see them in sentence examples. Now let's review last two kanji figures one more time. Our third kanji today, autumn kanji, can be remembered from the camping fire near the tree, which may cause the leaves change color. Its kun reading is aki, remember from Akira Kurosawa, and on reading is shu, remember his shootings were incredible. And today last kanji, winter kanji, the meaning of which can be remembered from skating snowman in winter. Its kun reading is fuyu, remember full European tour, snowman dreams, and from the same expression to, from tour is the on reading. Okay guys, that's all for today. At kanjimaya.com website, you can see details. Please visit Nature and People menu there and click on Day 17 and 18 links under Grade 2 title. Mata aimashou. Genki de ne?